Hey, home church family, it's time for our prayer scripture of the week. It's a day late, but it's okay. We're still going to do this together. If you have never done one of these with us, we release a scripture every single week that we pray through, that we add to our prayer journal, that we pray over. These are promises. These are things that belong to you and I that we want to remind ourselves with and we want to tap into. We want to pray the scripture out loud because when His word goes forth, it never returns void. And so come join us. Add this prayer scripture to your prayer journal. Add it to your prayer walk. Add it to your prayer time. Just add this prayer scripture. Go with me. We're going to dig deep. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3. This is a short book, but it's one of the most powerful letters that were written to the church of Thessalonica. Probably said that wrong, but I'm trying my best over here, okay? 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, we're going to read one verse, and that's what verse 3. Now, Paul starts to wrap this letter up, and he's asking for prayer for himself because he's saying that not everyone that he's talking to, not everyone that he's giving his life to has faith, and that some people were actively fighting against him. He knew that his life was soon going to be coming to an end and that his time was going to come to a close. He was running his race to the very end, and this was going to come towards the end. And so he's asking for the church to pray for him. And then he says this, go with me, 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse number 3. But the Lord is faithful. The Lord is faithful. He will establish you and guard you against the evil one. This is exciting. I had to stop myself because you just like read one sentence and you want to stop and talk about that. He's faithful. He's faithful when I'm not faithful. He's faithful when my circumstances say he's not faithful. He's faithful when I don't deserve someone to be faithful to me, when I'm actually doing things that would cause faithfulness to be taken away from me. He is faithful through all things. He's faithful when the job isn't there. He's faithful when the marriage is rocky. He's faithful when the relationships are tough. He's faithful in times of disaster. He's faithful in times of traumatic events. He's faithful in death. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful. And Paul reminds us that he's going to guard us. He's going to protect our ways. And he's going to watch over us to protect us from the plans of the evil one. Even when it seems like those plans are working, even when it seems like those plans are taking us in a different direction, even when it seems like those plans are actually prevailing against you, that you are in defeat, God is faithful. And we have to know that he will protect me. This is an encouragement. This is a promise. It belongs to you and I because he is faithful. And when our circumstances say they're not, when our circumstances say that he has forgotten about us, when our circumstances say that the evil one is winning against us, we have to remind ourselves that he is faithful. He will protect us. He is guarding our way. He's madly in love with us. Let that be an encouragement to you this week. Pray through it. Pray over it. Repeat it to yourself. I write it in our kitchen. Every time I walk in our kitchen, I quote it out loud to him. He is faithful. He's just, and he's going to protect us. I can't wait to be with you this week. We've got a lot of amazing things that we're going to present. We got a brand new guest speaker that will be with us this week. So come back, join us for the rest of this week as we release videos that are a blessing to you here at Home Church. And then this Friday, come see us. Come see us on Friday. We will be meeting in Metairie at one of our worship experiences. Also here in Destrehan, we'd love to see you. So come hang out with us. God bless you. Thank you.